Hi guys, this is Virendra from iDeserve. Today I'm going to talk about longest palindromic subsequence. Before understanding the palindromic subsequence, please go through these two videos here and here so that it will be easier to understand the question in consideration right now. Okay, so let's look at the problem statement for this. Given a string S, we need to find out the longest palindromic subsequence, that is straightforward, right? So given a string like this, we have multiple palindromes here, right? We have PSP, we have APA, and we have LPSPL, right? So we want to find out the longest one from these. The brute force solution for this is to compare all the subsequences and find the longest one. This would lead to an exponential complexity, right? So the better way is to use the longest common subsequence solution. We can reverse this particular string S in T and then take S and T and find the longest common subsequence between those two. Okay, so please go through the other two videos which are based on longest common subsequence and longest palindromic substring to understand what I'm saying here. But going further, for this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to discuss an algorithm which is based on the LCS algorithm. Okay, let's try to look at the recurrence relation for that particular algorithm. Suppose we have a function which looks like this, which takes a string and gives out the length of the longest palindromic subsequence. If you remember, in the longest common subsequence problem, what we did, if the characters matched, we trimmed out the characters, right? So here also we do the same, trim out the matching characters and then recompute the LPS for the remaining string. Since we are counting the length of the palindromic subsequence, and if the first and the last characters match, we have found two characters, right? So that's why we have 2 plus LPS of the remaining string. Okay, so the rule one is to trim both the characters if they match and recompute the LPS for the remaining string. Okay, so let's try to find out the LPS of the remaining string, which is PASPA. Here the first and the last characters do not match, right? If you remember, in longest common subsequence, in the second rule, what we used to do, if the characters did not match, we used to leave one character at a time and compute LCS for the remaining strings. And after doing that, we used to take the max of the length of the LPS for each of the trimmed strings, right? We'll do the same here. We'll leave one character at a time. Here we leave A and compute LPS of PASP, and here we leave P and we compute LPS of ASPA. Okay, and then later we'll take a max of these two. Okay, in this algorithm we have a matrix where the string represents the rows and the columns. This is similar to the approach that we took in longest common substring, longest common subsequence, and longest palindromic substring. So please check those videos out. This is similar to longest palindromic substring. Okay, we are going to look at substrings of length 1 to 7. 7 is the length of the given string. Okay, so we are going to go from length 1 to 7. And for each substring, what we are going to do is we are going to compare the first and the last characters. Okay, if the first and the last characters match, we trim those characters and we compute the LPS of the remaining string. And if they do not match, we trim one character at a time and then take the max. Those are the two rules we are going to follow henceforth. So let's look at the current length equal to 1, which is basically substrings of length 1, which are anyway trivially palindrome. Okay, so we are going to update all the single character palindromes from L to the final L here, right? So diagonally we have updated all the single character palindromes. Okay, let's go to current length equal to 2. So the substring in consideration here is LP. What are we going to do here? We are going to compare the first and the last character, right? What we see is they do not match. What do we do in that case? If they do not match, we have the second rule, right? Take one at a time, trim one at a time and take the max. So first we'll trim P. What is the length of the longest palindromic subsequence in the substring L? It is 1, right? And similarly, what is it for P? It is 1. What we do is take max of these two. So what is the max of these two? It is anything you take, right? By convention, we'll just take 1 from here, okay? We do the same for all the substrings of length 2, okay? Let's move on to substrings of length 3. So in this particular substring, LPA, we see that the first and the last characters do not match again. So what we do is we trim one at a time. Okay, so we trim out A and we have a remaining substring of LP. Okay, so what is the length of the longest palindromic subsequence of LP? It is 1. Okay, let's trim out L now. Okay, if we trim out L, we get the substring of PA. What is the length of the LPS of substring of PA? It is 1, right? What we have to do is take a max of these two. After taking the max of these two, we get 1. This happens for all the other substrings of length 3. So I'm not going to explain that. So let's go to substrings of length 4, which is LPAS. We do not have the first and the last characters matching. That's why we follow the second rule and we take the max, which is 1 here. Okay, let's move on to the next substring of length 4. We see that the first and the last characters match here. So what do? We trim out both the characters. We trim out T and we trim out P here. Okay, first and the last character. And the remaining substring is AS. Okay, so what is the length of the longest subsequence for the remaining substring? It is 1 here. Okay, from here we take 1, add 2 to that, because we found 2 more characters which can form a palindrome, right? So we add 1 plus 2, we get 3 here. So if you look at the substring of PASP, you can see that you have a palindrome here which is PAP and its length is 3. Okay, so let's move on to the next substring of length 4, which is ASPA. Okay, so here also we have first and the last characters matching. We follow the same procedure. We follow the first rule, which is basically trimming out the first and the last characters and adding 2 to the length of the longest palindromic subsequence for the remaining substring. The next substring of length 4 doesn't have first and the last characters matching. That's why we just take the max of the trimmed substrings one by one, right? So we follow the second rule in that case. Similarly, for substrings of length 5, we have the same case where first and the last characters do not match. Okay, same is the case for the next substring of length 5, and similarly for the last substring of length 5, we don't have the first and the last characters matching. Okay, so let's go ahead for length 6. They also do not have first and the last characters matching. We take the max. Similarly for the next substring of length 6, okay, you take the max. So let's look at substring of length 7, which is basically the whole string. What we have here is the first and the last characters match, right? So what we will do is we will trim out the first and the last characters and the remaining substring is PASPA. Okay, we are basically taking the length of the LPS for PASPA and adding 2 to that. We'll follow the first rule in this case. So the LPS of PASPA is 3 and we add 2 to that and we get 5 as the length of the longest palindromic subsequence. Okay, so let's look at the code. We have initializations here. This is the palindrome matrix where we store the lengths of the palindrome subsequences. I've shown the trimmed version of the matrix here. So the first case is where we have single letter palindromes. So we update all the lengths to 1. Okay, so the diagonals, right? So L, L, P, P, A, A, all those things. Okay, and then we go from length equal to 2 to length equal to N. N is the length of the string. Okay, for each length we get all the substrings of that length and we apply those two rules. If the first and the last characters match, what we do is we add 2 to the length of the LPS for the remaining trimmed string. Okay, if not, we trim one at a time, which is basically we trim from the end, we trim from the start, we take the max. Okay, please go through the code. I have given the code link here. Please let me know if you have any doubts or if I have made any mistakes. Thank you very much for watching the video. If you like the video, please comment below and also please subscribe our channel so that you are updated with our new videos. Thank you.